the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. The gracious Holy Trinity, as we approach the Triduum of Death, where we remember the saints in heaven and those in purgatory and those who have died and have lost salvation, we ask you, please, to continue to be with us and help us to meditate on the four last things: death, judgment, heaven, and hell. Help us to be right with you, now and always. Help us have a reverent fear of you, to work out our salvation in fear and trembling. This is asked, the Blessed Holy Trinity, in the name of Jesus Christ, the Lord, lives together with you, God the Father Almighty, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one undivided God, forever and ever. Amen. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. So here we come. We are in the middle of fall. The seasons are changing, and the church's liturgical calendar is winding down and fixing to start anew. As we get to the end of the church's year and the start of Advent, the readings become very apocalyptic and become very much a reminder of the nature of life, the cycle of life. These 3 days, however, before we even get into Advent, where as we start November and end October, we meditate on mortality, the four last things: death, judgment, heaven, hell, and another would be purgatory. One thing that all these have in common is death. You have to die in order to get to the next stage. And then there's judgment. And depending on how you lived your life and whether or not it is from God will determine whether or not if you've gone to heaven, purgatory, or hell. It is very crucial to meditate on the four last things because it's ultimately where everyone's going to go. It doesn't matter if you're rich or poor, successful or a failure, young or old, sick or healthy. We all approach the hour of death, and we all have to approach that throne which God will pronounce judgment on our souls, on whether or not we lived a life worthy of Him, or lived a life that is in spite of Him and risk possible damnation of our souls. It's something to think about. All Hallows' Eve, which is the night before All Saints' Day, is a day to reflect on those who have died not in friendship with God, and to realize that while it should bring a healthy awareness to us about our mortality, it should also bring reminders to us that some of our family and friends, and a lot of our strangers that we know, a lot of our acquaintances, don't make it. And that is a very sad, terrifying thing to think about. It should be humbling because we just don't know. Unless God provides a miracle or an apparition to let us know where that particular soul who has gone into the afterlife is, we just don't know. So we reflect on those who have died just in general. We hope they're in heaven. We hope they're in the process of purgatory even. And we definitely hope they're not in hell, but we also realize that there's a good portion of them there, and that hell is not empty, but has people in it. All Hallows Eve is known for its name because it precedes the coming day of All Saints, which is the day where the church celebrates all saints, the ones that are formally canonized and the ones that are just in heaven that we don't know about. Is the exact opposite of what All Hallows Eve is, because it is the triumphant, it is the most triumphant apex of the three feasts, if you think about it, because everyone that is of good will, everyone is striving to do God's will, is aiming toward heaven. If you get to purgatory, well, you're still getting to heaven, but you didn't quite make the bar, but you have now have a chance to get there. It's not a second chance, it's just a chance to get clean so you can get to heaven. So All Saints Day is the pinnacle. It is the highest of these three days, because it's all about celebrating the saints who are in heaven, all those who have gone before us, all our ancestors who have gone before us, who have made it, whether they be family, friends, acquaintances, or perhaps even enemies. Who knows, repentance is possible for us all, and God could call anyone prior to death, and they could have been saved. Only God knows. And the church can recognize more easily who is in heaven because of that's the charter, and we can recognize by miracles. There's a process of veneration, beatification, and canonization of people, and usually this takes a long, extensive investigation as to whether or not the person lived a heroic, virtue life in order to be qualified as a saint. And even then, these things can take time. Sometimes the miracles needed don't come for decades, maybe even centuries. There's some blessings out there that are still centuries old, and as far as I know, there hasn't been any approved miracles, but there's still blessings. They had two in order to get to blessed, but they haven't gotten that final one. We can't formally canonize them within the church. However, All Saints Day doesn't just celebrate the saints who are formally canonized, but celebrates those that we hope are in heaven that are not formally canonized, but are saints. Anybody who's in heaven is a saint. Anyone who's in heaven is holy, is with God, beholding Him in all His glory, all His splendor and majesty. There's nothing that is weak or foul about them. They are whole. So, now whether the degree of holiness or perfection, again, depends on God and them. And there's no jealousy in heaven, so it doesn't matter. There's no rivalry in heaven. So, regardless if you are one of the greatest saints or one of the lowest saints, or even, you know, just an unknown saint, you're a saint in heaven, basically. Regardless if you are formally canonized or not. Now let's move on to November 2nd, All Souls Day. This is a very important day because November marks the church's month of remembrance for the dead. You pray for the poor souls in purgatory who have died in friendship of God but still need to make atonement for their sins. And they are being purified and cleansed of their attachment to sin, so they may be worthy by the grace of God and the deliverance and power of God to finally, at last, behold that vision. They're eventually going to make it to heaven. As a matter of fact, they have kind of a paradox. They have joy, but they also have torment because they know that their sins are keeping them from entering the fullness of heaven, and they know that they still have to become clean. But they also, at the same time, behold the joy in their own anticipation of receiving heaven, receiving the Lord in His fullness. So they kind of have both worlds, and they aren't confined to measurements of our temporal world. So when they feel something, whether it's pain or pleasure or joy, it exceeds boundaries that we can't even possibly fathom. So the church has given indulgences, sacrifices, almsgiving options throughout the month of November, and really practically throughout the whole year for a variety of situations to pray. To pray for the living of the dead, to be granted an indulgence, either for yourself or for those in purgatory, is a very powerful aid to them, because it helps get them out. It helps get them out of their purification faster. Now, you can't buy indulgences. This is the whole thing Martin Luther misunderstood, is the soul has to be properly disposed in order to either gain a partial or plenary indulgence, either to yourself or to the soul in purgatory. You can't give it to somebody else who's living. They have to do it themselves. The soul has to be right with God and detached from certain sins and perform certain duties and expectations in order to gain the indulgence, either for themselves or for the souls in purgatory. So the Holy Trinity, or the Triduum of Death, All Hallows Eve, All Saints Day, and All Souls Day, are a very important time to remember and to reflect on mortality itself. As it comes in the fall, we see that the nature is beginning to decline and eventually succumb to winter. We see the trees changing colors, the leaves falling off, and eventually becoming bare, to where winter comes and reminds us of death and barrenness and darkness. So remember to pray for the dead and to reflect on these next 3 days here of mortality, because it's coming for us all. Stay in the state of sanctifying grace, go to confession often, repent of any sins, pray the Rosary, Divine Mercy Chaplet, read Sacred Scripture, go to Eucharistic Adoration, go to Holy Mass often if you can, and rely on the mercy of God and entrust your soul to the care of the Blessed Holy Trinity, for He is the only one who can shield you from the torments of the enemy. Remember, death comes for us all, and is not biased, but we have a Savior who has conquered death. Rely on His mercy and His power and His grace, His transformative grace, to make you better, to make me better, to make the world better. To rely on the holy power of Almighty God, the Blessed Holy Trinity, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, the one triune God, undivided in splendor and majesty, Alleluia. We trust in Him. I trust in Him. I hope you trust in Him. Remember your mortality, my friends. And entrust your soul to the care of God. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Heavenly Father, we ask you please to shield us tonight, to help us, to keep us close to you, purify our hearts and minds from all attachment to sin, that we may grow in virtue, righteousness, holiness, and sanctification, bringing sanctity to our souls, by the blood of Christ and His sacred sacrifice on the cross, and by His triumph and resurrection and glorious ascension. May these merits protect us and bring to us safe passage to heaven. And by the grace of the Holy Spirit, fill us with the divine life of you, that we may have life and radiate to others, and be able to receive the sacraments in a unfiltered, more pleasing manner. O Blessed Holy Trinity, one triune God, please hear the prayers of not only myself, but all the others who appeal to you, because you're the one undivided God, the creator of all things, and you have conquered death. Hallelujah. In the name of Christ, I pray, to the glory of God the Father, who is eternal, to the glory of God the Son, who is eternal, to the glory of God the Holy Spirit, who is eternal, one undivided God, eternal, co-equal, co-eternal, one in splendor and majesty, now and forever. Amen. Hallelujah. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Peace.